I request Professor Kiran Mai to welcome our chief guest, Sri Krishna Nayar Garu, with a bouquet. I request Professor Lakshmi Kumari to welcome our guest of honor, Sri Ramakrishna Garu, with a flower of bouquet. I take the privilege of introducing Sri Ramakrishna Garu, our guest of honor for this today's inaugural and orientation program. Sri Ramakrishna Chiruvuri is an executive director at Association of Management Development Institutions in South Asia, AMDISA. He is postgraduated in management and alternative dispute resolution, and he possessed several years of top and senior levels of management experience as an employee, entrepreneur, and consultant across diverse verticals in manufacturing, service, IT, non-profit sectors. And he has planned and he has organized various seminars and events which are of national and international repute. And he is a peer review and NGO workshops he conducted, South Asian management forums he organized in South Asia, and LR on financial viability was through securing funds from different organizations. And he administered the construction and completion of South Asian Secretariat buildings of the association, and he publishes the quarterly South Asian Journal of Management, an internationally recognized management journal indexed by the International Database Service entities EBSCO and ProQuest. He administered the postdoctoral and doctoral fellowship programs funded by the Commonwealth Secretariat. He liaised and networked with professional management development associations worldwide. And coming to his past experience, he was an advisor, projects and programs at Academy of Corporate Governance. He was a vice president at SP Software Private Limited. And he was a general manager at ATM Incorporation, CEO at Padmaja Infotech Limited, managing director at Splendor Ceramics Private Limited, managing director at Klammann Porcelains Limited, Assistant Administrative Manager at Indian Airlines Limited. With his vast experience, let us have a drop from the ocean of experience that he has and the knowledge that he has. Sir, I welcome you to address our students.
Mr. Krishna Nayar, Dr. Mishra, Dr. Srinivas Murthy, faculty, friends, a very good morning to all of you. In fact, I was very surprised when Professor Mishra requested me to come here and talk to you. I mean, I start thinking about my own time when I was a student and I was sitting on the other side. But anyway, there are two parts in which I would like to talk to you today. One is to tell you about our organization and how it is connected to management and how IP as part of that system. And the second is a general perception which over 40 years of experience has shown and from which I have learned, and to share some of those aspects with you. Firstly, about the organization. I head an organization which is called the Association of Management Development Institutions in South Asia, acronym AMDISA, AMDISA. You can, for those of you who are very keen to know more about it, Google AMDISA and you will get it, or if you wish, you can take the URL www.amdisa.org. There you will know a lot about who we are and what we do and how we do. But in short, to introduce you to it, we are an association which is recognized by SAARC. I'm sure all of you must be familiar with SAARC. SAARC is the South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. It's an intergovernmental agency, and where within it, with the current heavy emphasis on the SAARC concept and the present government's very, very overtly expressed keenness on the promotion of the SAARC concept, the SAARC has gained some relevance and some significance in our present day. Being a management development institution, we have all the leading management development institutions in South Asia as members of our institution. And the deans and directors of all these institutions, they are the representatives of their respective institutions on this body. Institute of Public Enterprise, of which you are now a very, very integral constituent, is a distinguished member of our association. We have about 243 institutions all over South Asia, not very many, because the process of membership is also a little bit regimented and has certain procedural limitations, so not everybody can become a member of this. To tell you something, all the IIMs, ISB, and all the leading institutions in Pakistan, in Bangladesh, in Maldives, in Sri Lanka, in Bhutan, are members of our, and Nepal, are members of the association. There is a lot of interdependence between the members, in the sense there are, we do encourage them to take on this student exchange programs inter se, that is, we only act as a catalyst, we don't really get into it, or faculty exchange programs, which probably on an inter-institutional basis is facilitated by us. This is one aspect. The second aspect is we run a quality assurance program. This quality assurance program is a very prestigious one. It's called the South Asian Quality Assurance System, with an acronym SAQS, S-A-Q-S. Till date, about 35 institutions have entered the SAQS process all over South Asia. IPE is one of the privileged ones to be accredited under the South Asian Quality Assurance System. Now, this is a very good system which benchmarks institutions on international lines. We have evolved this system in collaboration with the European Foundation for Management Development, that is the EFMD acronym, and evolved this particular SAQS on the lines of the European Quality Improvement System. Now, what it means to you as a student? All this is fine. Whatever I have said is on a very macro basis, but how does it affect you? It tells you that the curriculum, the faculty engagement, is all of international standards. So what you are going to imbibe, what you are going to get, is something which is on internationally accepted principles and standards. This is the meaning of it for you. What does it mean for the corporates? To the corporate, it means that this particular institution, that is the Institute of Public Enterprise, is accredited, is an accredited one. It has got systems and infrastructure equivalent to internationally accepted norms and standards. So this is where it gives you, in very short, this is what it is about. Accreditation is not an easy job. It takes about 2 to 3 years before an institution gets accredited. A peer review team visits, comprising of international members who comes and sees and assesses the institution, its infrastructure, its faculty, its students, and the level of and the kind of delivery, the kind of placements that are being done by the institution. Now that is all that it takes a look at before the award is given. Why I'm telling you all this? I'm telling you all this because you need to be very proud that you've got into the right institution. There is a lot of hullabaloo. There's a lot of media banging on the mind, which talks of different kinds of institutions and different kinds of environments and different kinds of facilities and different. So all that confuses the stakeholder. The stakeholder community, which is primarily going to be affected by it, is the students, and then they get confused. To give you one or two examples which will illustrate the point better, students have become very conscious. They are not what they are or what they used to be in those good old days. Today they have access to huge mechanisms in the shape of a global information system through the internet. They all go through the web and then evaluate an institution whether it is really good or not. How do I do this evaluation? I'm sitting on the other side of the fence. I'm not on that side. So I do not know how your mind is working, the present day generation. I can only tell you how our mind used to work about 30 to 40 years back. A student wrote to us about 5 months or 6 months ago, no names, about a particular institution to which he had got admission. And believe me, I was myself surprised because I really don't index the kind of popularity which my website has or which, though we have a counter and we know how many hits we get and Google Analytics tells us as to how we are shaping or how we are faring and what we are doing. But to get a feedback of a kind, I got a couple of feedbacks, one of which was from a student himself. He said he didn't know anybody. He just wrote bang from the contact us on the website. He said, I've got admission in so-and-so institution. I have to join it. But when I go through their website, I'm informed that they are a member of AMDISA. That's a simple thing. I mean, he didn't know. But when I went to the AMDISA website to cross-check, I find that that institution's name is not there. Please tell me, please respond back urgently, as my career is at stake and I do not want to join an institution which does not portray a correct impression on the web, on a public dissemination system. We ensured that the reply went back within a couple of hours. It came to our notice because we are very, very conscious and we go through the trying to get a feel of the pulse of what is going on in our environment. And then we wrote back saying that particular institution was a member, but having defaulted on membership fee, and when we asked them, they did not renew their membership, so they were removed from membership. Now you take your call whether you want to join them or don't want to join them. This is an illustration of how much of consciousness and how much of diligence is being carried out even by the student community, the people who are about to go in for another example. An institution was accredited under SACS. It had another campus also. So what they did was, the other campus also wrote that it was accredited under SACS. I didn't know. I mean, we cannot keep on seeing everybody's website, but then when somebody points out, then you come to know it. So what they did was, they, how this guy is connected with that, I don't know, but he did write. He said, I am a stakeholder in the system. So-and-so is saying he is accredited under SACS, And having gone to AMDSA's website and seen the list of institutions, it is so-and-so campus of the same name which is accredited, but not so-and-so. We took it up. It happens to be a public sector organization, mind you, government-owned organization. We took it up with the director of that institute and the other institute, and we got to see that that particular thing was removed. And then we told them that if you wish to get accredited, come back again and then talk to us. We will talk to you. This is the level of awareness which has come into society. These examples are only told to make you also equally conscious that if you are doing it, you are not the only one. There are so many other people in the environment who are doing it. The awareness has become so, what you call, intense that there is a simultaneous reaction to find out what the thing is all about. The other saying goes, no, you can fool some of the people for some of the time and all the people for some of the time, but you cannot fool all the people all the time. So you can be on the web, you can write anything you want, you can do anything. Same thing applies on the curriculum, CVs which you people write. We get so many CVs. I'm sure your IT segment would know what about it and how much of, you know, because everything is on the web and you have so many access to so many tools, you pick up the, you know, jargons and nomenclatures from some other CVs and then plant it onto your CV, and then, well, you may be lucky to some extent and get away with it, but then there are, sooner or later, somewhere or the other, you may get caught and then it may ricochet on you. So this is one aspect which is has come about as an offshoot of what I was telling you. I have told you all in the context of the fact. One is telling you what we are. Second is telling you how you are. You can be able to make out what is being said on the web by cross verification. And the third thing, telling you that you are currently enrolled in a system which is of international standards. Make the best use of it. That takes care of one part of what I wanted. We have several other things. We bring out a journal called the South Asian Journal of Management. We hold conferences, events, all kinds of things that we do. And then faculty development, what you call programs, which we collaborate with member institutions and lend our branding and co-branding along with them. Those are the things that we do. But the most important things for you was, yes, one is that you are a member of the South Asian community. If you wish or if you want any faculty student exchange programs and things, want to participate in them, approach through your institution. They approach us, we find out, name which countries you may be interested in, then we work it so that this could be facilitated on an inter-institutional basis. The second thing that we could do is this, on your placement and when you go. Some of you take the institutional placement, some of you may want to take a direct route, some of you may want to go for entrepreneurship. We do not know what will happen, how the 2 years will shape up, how your mind will, what kind of a churning takes place in your own mind, and how the evolution of the thought process will take place. But whatever you want to do, you can project, you should project that you have come from an institution which has these kinds of value systems in place, or rather, and has this kind of a credibility, so that the person in front, even if he wants to verify or cross-verify, he can do it and satisfy himself. It's for you also to propagate your own institution. Be proud of your alma mater. Ultimately, this is the link that you will have on your CV for as long as you are alive, whether you like it or don't like it. I'm an MBA myself, but I passed out decades ago. In that time, we read from American hardbacks, not even Asian Economy editions. We came out in a very glossy world of America, but when we saw what India was, we were thoroughly disillusioned with what it was and what we were seeing and what people and what kind of responses and reactions were there to us. There was a lot of hostility, but today an MBA is very, very gladly accepted and listened to. So you have that advantage. At the time of opening, if you are able to establish your credibility, you have something. So if you don't impress on the first, that is, say, no? The first impression, if you make, half your battle is won. It all depends on how you give your punch and what punch you give. Coming to the other aspect which I wanted to tell is, see, you are going to learn a lot. You're going to see a lot over a period of 2 years. There is an approach which I don't know. I still see it fairly rampant. A thing that is because you go through the exam process and you have to give it. That is the system that has. So you try to mug up or you cram up or something like that. And later on when you come in and you are quizzed in an interview or a interaction, you falter because your concepts and fundas are not very clear. Whatever you are told, try to, you know, assimilate it and understand it. After that, you can put it in your own language. You don't require the bookish language. You can be original, and that is what is will stand you in a long set because your concepts become very solid. If the concepts are not solid and you simply read for the sake of reading because you have to get through the exam to get that degree, yes, you have to get through, you have to get the degree. But then how can you be a better person? How can you be more useful? How can you be perceived as a value proposition by the person in front? That is what is very important from you, and that will come only by when a question is asked, you are able to quickly respond to the situation at that point of time and give an answer. Several concepts which were told several years ago, they are still very valid in my own memory, and I think that they are to be applied. I have my own approach, and I don't want to enter into any controversies by talking of some of the concepts and things like that, particularly in behavioral sciences, theory X, Y, and X, Y, and Z, and whatnot, and all those things that you are going to be reading.